All right, still a few pieces to iron out between now and October. You can see some of the Flames' notable RFAs right now. Matthew Tkachuk about to get paid this summer. You can see he's 21 as of October 2nd, coming off that cap hit of $925,000. The entry-level contract. Speaking of goaltenders, we talked about Cam Talbot, that signing. How about David Riddick coming off a good season up there in Calgary? 27 years old, cap hit of $800,000. Sam Bennett, Andrew Mangiapane, and Ryan Lomberg as well. Some of the guys that they still have to iron out deals with moving forward. For more on the Flames, we welcome in Flames host on Sportsnet, Ryan Leslie, to the show right now. Ryan, what is the latest with Matthew Tkachuk in that RFA contract situation?
He was just in town, actually. He took part in the Calgary Stampede, the greatest outdoor show on earth. He was riding a horse and really embracing it, which was a neat sign because, obviously, he is a very big part of this organization. And I can tell you that the discussions are routine and very positive and with some real regularity. Brad Treliving, the Flames general manager, and, of course, the Tkachuk camp have an ongoing dialogue. Nothing to really worry about as I talk to both sides. It just remains, I think pretty much on the right pace. And I know there's some discussion about other RFAs and what that's going to mean and that impact that it may or may not have on Matthew. It remains to be seen. But this is a player who remains very much engaged in the entire process with the organization and obviously his agent.
Ryan, what can you tell us about possible trade rumors we're hearing about a TJ Brody or a Travis Hamonic? Because it seems like their names have been in the mix. Are these guys that the Flames are maybe looking to move out with just 1 year left on each of their contracts?
Well, I think that's it, isn't it, guys? Because I think sort of jump to that when it is a player's final year of a contract and you start to think about how good they are and you can see the numbers for both. Let's keep in mind both players had really good seasons and bounce back seasons. And TJ Brody was a fourth round pick a number of years ago. He has just come on as a number one part of that pairing with Giordano, 24 minutes or so a night, and he really did bounce back. Travis Hamonic, Brad Treliving gave up a first rounder and 2 second rounders to get him. Very integral parts of that blue line, both really good. And probably no surprise, I think everybody heard about a report out of Toronto that had Brody as part of the Kadri situation. That Kadri situation really started when their regular season came to an end a little too early. And there was obviously some reports out there that those players were going to be linked. Those discussions, I can tell you, never went as far as maybe that report would indicate. And I think we all know that a lot of these trade conversations take place and dissolve with some regularity as well, too. So when we start to hear about them, we blow them up a little bit. But that one, there were some discussions about it. I would be very surprised, on the Hamonic front, if that ever were to happen. I think TJ Brody is a player that a couple of teams covet. Makes a lot of sense. Both players are players that other teams would covet. But I really think that at this point, it would be a surprise if a guy like Travis Hamonic were involved at this point, and I'd be really surprised about TJ Brody in the end when it's all said and done. I would be very surprised if you didn't see them both with the Flaming C this year.
All right, we talked about the acquisition of goaltender Cam Talbot. How do the Flames feel about their goaltending tandem with Talbot and David Riddick maybe splitting time next season?
Yeah, I think they're really comfortable and confident in it. Brad Treliving and Bill Peters both have a little history with Cam Talbot going on the international stage. And David Riddick really turned a lot of heads, and you can see the numbers, how good they are. And this is a player who still has to get paid, still has to get a new contract. But in terms of what they have, a 1A, 1B, a lot of confidence as they had to say goodbye to a guy like Mike Smith. But now David Riddick can kind of be that guy with some real healthy competition. It seems like that's what this thing is. And I think they want to see what Riddick is and can still be capable of after a really good year. I think Talbot seems to be a real competitive and complementary piece for their goaltending situation. It's going to be fun. I mean, I know Treliving has mentioned publicly that, he still thinks that they can get a little bit more. Here we are talking about bounce back seasons. They think they can get him back to where he was early on in his career.
Ryan, let me ask you about the situation with James Neal. He was signed to a five-year contract last offseason. It did not work out last year. Really not a good year for him. Is there any way they can move this contract, $5.75 million against the cap? Is there anything they can do with that, or are they just going to hope he can come to camp and get himself going?
Geez, this seems to be the theme, doesn't it, to the bounce back. If they ever needed a guy to turn things around right now, it would be James Neal. It did not go well, as you say. And to be honest, I don't know personally how many teams are lined up for the services of James Neal at this point. Now, this is a proud player. This is a player who's had success. He's used to it. And I know he was very angry and did not hide from the discussion at the end of the year when the heat was on. And he was a healthy scratch in that final game in the postseason. And now it's on himself, and he's owned it. I want to see if he's got the legs still. I want to see if he's got that ability to kind of turn things around, because that is a hefty contract. And that is a player who's, you know, got to find and find some speed in his game, or rediscover rather that scoring touch, because it was non-existent. He did not duck the media throughout the season. It was hard on him. And he's, as I say, a proud veteran who is used to having some success. I'm really curious to see what he does this offseason that helps him bounce back in the fall.
Yeah, we'll see if the real deal can reinvent himself next season, coming up in a Flame sweater. Ryan, thank you so much. Enjoy the summer or what's left of it, and we'll talk to you again, I'm sure, down the road at some point next year.
Appreciate it. Thanks for having me, guys.
All right, Ryan Leslie covers the Flames on a regular basis for Sportsnet up north in Canada.